Welcome back to our second online seminar with the topic Robot Programming Made Easy. I think, yeah, C++, Java was yesterday, and today we will show you that IGES can show you how easy it is to program a robot with our robot software. Yeah, for the overview, we will give you again a robot overview, which kinematics we have in the LCA universe, then what is the IGES robot control, so it means software and control unit, then a best practice application and live programming, because we will show you today how easy it is to program a robot. So that means we will show you how easy it is to program a matrix as well. Yeah, so my name is Julian. I'm at IGES since a couple of years, and I am product manager for the business unit of Locus Automation. Next to me is Sebastian. Hello, Sebastian.
Yeah, hi from my side. I'm Sebastian. I'm just 1 year at IGES and also at the Locus Automation team. My focus is on the Rebel, but I will show you later. Yeah, to the beginning, what kind of kinematics we have in our program. The flexible kinematics are our robots with 4 to 5 DOFs, degrees of freedom, with a payload up to 3 kilograms and a precision of around about plus minus 0.5 millimeters. For very fast picking, we have our 3-axis Delta robotics for 3D fast picking, and we have a payload of 5 kilograms, precision of plus minus 0.5 millimeter, and a speed of up to 60 picks per minute. Individual gantry systems, we have line gantries, room gantries, and
flat gantries.
Exactly. In our standard program, we have a payload up to 20 kilograms, a precision of 0.3 millimeters plus minus, and a range of up to 3 by 3 meters and 1 meter in height. Perfect. Our next kinematics is our first cobot. It's a Rebel. We have it in 2 sizes, the 4-axis and the 6-axis. We have a payload up to 3 kilograms. Precision is round about plus minus 1 millimeter. For, again, faster picking in only 2 axes, we have our 2-axis Delta robot, where we can go up to 100 picks per minute. And our last kinematic is our SCARA kinematic. It is also a little bit individual because we can adjust the length of the last axis
of the z-axis,
up to 3 meters. In our standard program, we have a payload also of 2 kilograms and a precision round about 0.5 millimeters.
Yeah, and where can the SCARA robot be adjusted, or where can we use the SCARA robot for which application? For example, laboratory applications for pick and place of, yeah, laboratory products. I don't know.
Yeah.
All these products are programmed with our IGES robot control, or can be programmed with our IGES robot control. So this is a free software and no license, or there's no license needed. And this is a short overview. But after this quick video, we will show you how easy it is to program a matrix with our new Rebel. So different pre-configurations in the software, and all the time we can use each kinematic. So I will change right now to the software. So this is the real software with our robot to get a short overview. So we have pre-configurations on open projects with Delta robots, with gantry systems, with SCARA robots, the Rebel as well with single axis, the RoboLinks, the articulated arms, and as well separate joints. Configuration, so project configurations like external axis, light virtual boxes, configure robots. So if you have another size of the gantry system, you can choose there your correct length. Configure interfaces like cameras, like cloud, CRI interface, Modbus. But Sebastian will tell you something more about these things. Let's start with the programming. So we choose the right configuration, the Rebel robot, click on connect. So how do we get a connection via Wi-Fi and via Ethernet? Two possibilities. So load all, reset, enable. Robot is ready to run. As you can see, the real robot on the side. we can use the joint motion, where we move the robot via single axis in X, axis 1 up to axis 6, or we are using the motion type base. That means Cartesian movement X, Y, Z, and the robot, or all robot joints are working to each other and together. So, to program a matrix, it's not a big deal, let me say. It's very easy to program the matrix. Let's start with the first motion, or let's start with the first point. So if we use the motion type joint, I will use the axis like this. I will turn axis 5 as well like this, for example, axis 5 like this, so, and then I will add action joint motion. And as you can see, all parameters are synchronized. So let's start with the matrix. We are going on flow loop matrix. So now we are doing a 3x3 matrix. So we have three lines and we have in all nine positions. 3x3 exactly, nine positions. And for the first position, we need my point A, my point B, my point C. So I will copy this one right now and move to the first position with the base coordinate system. So my point A is, I will move down and move with the X direction like this. So this is our first position, action, variable definition, position, and as you can see here, I will change the variable to my point A because of we need position 1 or position A, and as you can see here, X, Y, Z coordinates are synchronized. So my point B, just move in Y direction, in the minus Y direction, like this. This is our my point B. I will copy this one as well. Special variable definition, position, change the name to variable my point B because this is our second point. And now we will add my point C. So I have to move back to the Y coordinate, as you can see, 223.9 in plus 223.9, 223.9. So like this, perfect. And now we have to move in the Y direction, in the X direction, in minus, like this. Yeah. Just to get a quick overview, so my point C, let's copy my point C as well. So my point A, my point B, and special variable definition, position, variable my point C, perfect. So now we got all three corners which are needed for the matrix, but now we have to also install the variable motion linear, because we need the maximum, or we need the speed, how fast we should move in the matrix as well. So I will change it to 150, for example, with an acceleration of 50% is more than enough right now to show you, or to get an overview of this. So we will add as well relative motions with linear in the Z direction, minus 20, for example, so that you can see as well that he's moving down in the matrix. Then action, relative motion, base as well, plus 20, something like this. And yeah, that's it for now. So now we are moving in the matrix. He's moving up, down, up, down, up, down, or down, up, sorry, other way around. And if you want to grab something else, we can also implement a picking position in the matrix directly. But I think for now it's more than enough. If you want to learn more about these, we have a lot of sample programs pre-configured on our website with videos, with descriptions and so on. So everything that you can do it by yourself. For now, we will save it. Rebel matrix, save. So it's already saved. It's already loaded. If the program is not loaded, please go and load Rebel matrix, open it, and then you will find as well the matrix. So let's press on play, and the robot is doing his matrix. Oh, pathgen error. Ah, very good that it's live, because I forgot the variable target. So I have to copy this one and have to paste it here inside. So now there will no more error come. Press play. Oh, let's see. Here we go. And as you can see, the real robot is moving. We are moving with the relative motion as well in Z down, 20 millimeters up and down. And if we change the matrix right now to 5x5 or 10x10, doesn't matter. Yeah, I think this is very quick and very easy. So I think so. Hopefully you as well.
Yes.
If not, just give us some feedback and yeah. And the software is for free. Test before invest is the slogan for us. So if you want to download the software, please let us know, or please go on the webpage. You can download the software directly. But yeah, let's show you something else, what the robot control can do and what is possible with a robot control. So we've showed you the matrix programming right now. But we will go back to the presentation and tell you something more about the robot control unit.
Yes, what are our specs from the IRC? So one big thing is we have a teach-in function in our linear robots. So it means at our gantries or delta robots, you can directly grab them at the axis and move the robot or the kinematic to his position. And then you can directly save in the position into the program. So it means if you want to do very quick and fast a program for simulating at this robot, you can grab it, move it to his position, save the position, move it back to the next position. And so you can write a program very, very fast. To our interfaces, we have a lot of interfaces for our software, from Modbus TCP/IP. We have digital DIOs as normal. We have our Ethernet connection,
exactly.
Our own CRI interface. We have a ROS connectability and so on. For normal connecting to our robots or to our robot kinematics and our control, we usually go with our Ethernet communication, or we can connect via Wi-Fi. For programming, like Julian showed us, we have a lot of motion types, like circular motions, linear motions, joint motions. We have a matrix, as Julian showed you. We can calculate something, we can do math.
Interpolation,
yeah. And so on. Yeah, and as Julian say, we have a lot of sample programs online where you can look how to program something for our kinematics. And the important thing, it's free it's free and no license. So you can multiply it on every PC in your company.
Test before invest.
Exactly. Yeah? Test before invest.
And
exactly. Where is it used? To show some real applications from our customer who do their projects only with our robot control. We see on the one side a gluing application from a customer with our gantry system. Very precision in this case, and it's fully done by our robot control. It's implemented with some other technique, but it's only controlled by our software. And on the right side, we see a Delta robot controlled by a camera. So that is something we don't spoke about, right?
Not yet. So
yeah, so this is also possible with our software. You can easily connect in a camera system to control your robot. So it means the camera will get the master controller of our robot for fast picking applications, like here with the Delta. So it's also possible. So it's a fully industrial robot control. Yeah.
Exactly.
Did I forgot something, Julian?
Yeah, I think we have a switch right now to
the integration.
Exactly. So the marketplace, RBTX means it's a robot marketplace which combines IGUS products, but not only IGUS robots, as well other robot companies. But we want to talk about IGUS products. And tomorrow we have another seminar where we will discuss more about the marketplace. But to get a short and a quick overview, we at IGUS say we have robots and we have the control unit. But for all integrations, for all full solutions, we need a gripper, we need a vision system, we need a feeding system, we need safety systems, and so on, and so on, and so on. And in combination with the marketplace, we can combine everything and it's compatible to each other. So we give a 100% compatibility to all our systems or to all our systems on the marketplace itself. So if you want to buy a gripper, if you want, or if you need a gripper, if you need a vision system, if you need the robot, everything is fitting to each other, everything is fitting to all the systems, and everything can be controlled with our robot control.
Exactly.
And with our robot software as well. So, and I think that's it from our side. If you are interested in to learn more, please contact us. Please visit us at Cologne directly. Please visit us on our webpage.
Yeah, you can book a free meeting with us, contact us. We will show you. We have a big customer testing area here where we can show you all our robot kinematics, make a little small programming with you live. We are remote. And yeah,
exactly.
I think
that's
it from our side.
Perfect.
Yeah. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your time. And the Rebel is also saying thank you, I guess. He is moving his matrix. He's doing his matrix as well. So,
yeah, thank you very much. And hope we see you in the next video.
Exactly. Thank you. Bye-bye.